Mama Sweeties, welcome to another video. This video here is a cooking video. As I told you earlier, I started the ketogenic diet. So I told you guys I would put some little recipes that I found on YouTube. This one here I found from, it was two of them actually. And one was Kayla Does Keto, and the other one is Keto Connect. I think I mentioned them before in my other video. So yeah, my video when I was showing you things I brought from Whole Foods. So yeah, they had a recipe with chicken crust pizza, and that's what we're making today, our chicken crust pizza. Let me put this out right now. I just came from the dentist, probably like 30, 45 minutes ago. They numbed the side of my mouth, so I will be talking a little weird, but you should still get the gist of this recipe that I'm trying to put out, but I'm hungry, and they told me I could eat like an hour after I left from the dentist, so 15 minutes I can eat, and I'm hungry, so I just want to put this out there while I'm doing it. So if you want to watch more, you want to see how I put this together, stay tuned. I'm going to show you all the ingredients that you need, and let's get cooking. First off, I preheated my oven to 350. They say 400, but we in the South, it's hot down here, humid, so I did it at 350. The season, I'm using chicken breasts that I purchased from, this whole chicken breast, a pack of chicken breasts that I purchased from Walmart. The recipe called for ground chicken, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to grind my own chicken in my food processor. The ingredients you put in now, it depends on what you want in your crust. I want Italian seasoning, crushed red peppers for a little bite. I have this garlic pepper seasoning grinder, Himalaya pink salt, onion powder, garlic powder. It asks for a 4 cup of Parmesan cheese. I got the grated one. Well, I have another bag I got from Walmart, the little Great Value brand. We use the rest of these. And if I run out, then I'll go to that one. And some mozzarella cheese. And as far as the toppings go, is whatever you want to put on your pizza. This is just the crust. But whatever you want to put on there, have fun, have at it. That's what I plan on doing. Okay, so first thing first, I'm going to grind my So right now I have a bowl sitting on a scale, and I'm going to measure out my cheeses that I'm going to put in there. We're going to mix it. See, got everything in there. So I'm going to mix it. Y'all, I'm not playing with this. I hate touching raw meat, ground meat, chicken meat, pork chop, pig meat. I don't care. But you know the other meat I ain't scared. I'm just playing. This is a family show. So, I got all my seasoning in there, mixed up in there. Let's move this out the way. And I have a pizza plant pan. Don't make fun of my pizza pan, y'all. It's a little rusty, dusty, but you know, it still works. And I have parchment paper that I'm going to put on top of it. That parchment sounds funny, I know. So, after you mix your cheese inside your your chicken mixture, you're gonna take it and I'm gonna put it on the pizza pan. So let me make sure that you, who is this calling me? I am filming. I am not about to answer this phone. Let me show you my mama. Y'all hold tight. It's my son. Son, I'm going to call you back when I'm done with this, because I know you watch my videos. I'm going to call you back when I'm done. So now, as you can see, I have the mixture on my pan. And I'm just going to press it out. Press it out real thin, as thin as I can make it. Oh, God. I think I'm about to give in, y'all, and touch this meat with my hand. I don't want to. But And I'm gonna put it in the oven for maybe 20 to 30 minutes.
On my toppings. I have pizza sauce, Great Value from Walmart. It has 4 grams of carbs, 1 gram of diet fiber, 3 grams of sugar, in 1/4 cup. So let me show y'all this. Focus, there you go. In 1/4 cup. Then I have some, this is the pork. You know how you get the roll of pork? The pork roll. So I just fried it all up at one time. The sausage, the breakfast sausage roll, that's mild pork. So I just fried all that up one time, put in a Ziploc bag so whenever I just want to crumble someone's on eggs or some vegetables I have, I just put that on there. So I'm going to put this on my pizza. And then I have some cut up chicken. Let me show you what kind of chicken this is. This here is a John Soul's fully cooked chicken breast strips with red meat chicken fajita. So yeah, I got this. Can you see that? And it has, in 3 ounces, it's 2 grams of carbs, 1 gram of fat. So this is perfect for low carb. And just to let you know, this is my first meal of the day. 1/4 cup, which is 28 grams of sugar, less than 1 gram of carb. And cheddar cheese, mozzarella cheese. And also you have to have mozzarella cheese on top of your pizza too. And this here is 1 gram of carb. And 1/3 cup. Okay, so the pizza crust is ready. Let me show you guys. Don't that look delicious? Pop up off the pan. Look at that, nice and golden brown. I did it for like, look at the bottom. You don't see the bottom? I did it for like maybe 40 minutes because, again, excuse me, but I'm a little anal about raw meat. So I want to make sure my meat was cooked. So yeah, I did a little longer than what was suggested. I can say 20 to 30 minutes. I'm like, maybe 20 minutes. So now I have my toppings. I have my pizza sauce. So it's just pizza sauce. I'm gonna measure out 1/4 cup. I already measured my meats out. I'm gonna take it and put it on my pizza crust. Get a spoon and just spread it out. I want you guys to see. So we gotta make this 1/4 stretch. I don't really like saucy pizza anyway, so this will work for me. Then we'll leave the outside so it can look like a real pizza crust. So see? We have the top. 14. Okay, that's 12. That's good. So, put it at the bottom. Because I want it at the cheese at the bottom of my pizza and underneath the meat and on top of the meat. Put that on there. I need a plastic in my pizza. I already measured my meat. This is a 1 ounce. Is it 1 ounce? Yeah, 1 ounce of the mild pork that's already been fried and crumbled, and I'm just gonna put it on my pizza. I wish I had some bacon. I should have fried some bacon. I usually have already bacon that's already been cooked, but I don't have none. I ate it all. And then I got my chicken, and then I'm gonna put it back in the oven for. Put it in the oven, but I'm gonna put it on the broil. I know y'all can tell that I'm speaking a little better. The numbness is wearing off. Praise the Lord, thank you, Jesus. So I think I almost bit my tongue a couple of times. So this is the pizza, how it looks before I put it in the oven. I'm gonna put it in the oven for about 10 seconds, 15 seconds, just so it just get bubbly and all the cheeses and the meat get all nice and hot and melted. So all my cheese on my pizza because I don't want all. On this pizza. All right, guys, the pizza is out of the oven. I just took it out. Look how delicious it looks. close up. Yes, yes. Like the top is endless. Like I wish I would have had some bell peppers, some black olives, but I kind of want to make it simple. I was trying to make it more simple right now. So I'm gonna take it off the little pizza pan that I have. And I got my cutter. So let's cut into it. Now I don't expect it to be all crispy like a regular crust, of course. Definitely different than normal. Ooh, look at that, guys. Let's get a close up on there. Well, not too far back. I told you I didn't want to try my face. But look at that. Y'all see? Ooh, damn it. Look at me. Y'all see? Focus. That's the pizza. You see how thick the crust is? It's a little thicker than what I want it to be. But let me show y'all to see. It's a little thicker than what I want it to be. But I don't feel like pressing on that meat too long. As long as it's cooked, I'm glad I did cook it a little longer than what we'll say, because my crust is a little thicker than with the ones I've seen on YouTube before. So I'm glad I did let it cook a little longer. So I'm putting my plate. I'm so excited about this. I'm try this and take a bite. My mouth is salivating. I got feeling back in my mouth. I can feel. And I'm gonna take a taste. Shut up, shut up and just eat. Bruh, this is good. This is really good. That's really, I really didn't expect it to be that good, but it's good. It's really good. It has the herbs and the seasoning. And you got that little bite I was talking about with the crushed peppers. Good. Oh. Well, I finished eating this because it's delicious. The dog is begging for some. I'm giving him a little piece of here. Piece of chicken. It's delicious. You guys should try it. Try it. I'm telling you, try it. It's easy. It's real easy. Like I said, you can buy the chicken already ground, or you can grind your own chicken. Put whatever toppings you want on. Make sure it's keto friendly. And enjoy. Let me answer this one because people just keep calling me like that. That's my husband. Okay, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure. Hold on, honey. Let me end this video. Thank you guys for watching this video. Hope you enjoy. If you want any more recipes, I'll let me know. I'll put it on there. Thank you again. Thanks for watching. Make sure you subscribe. Make sure you like. Make sure you share. Again, if you have any more keto-friendly recipes, let me know and I will try it out. Thanks. Bye. Hello. Yeah.